is Buddhist Psychotherapy? Now there is a trend in the field of psychology and psychotherapy to discuss about Buddhist Psychotherapy. Actually, if we learn, study Buddhist psychological principles comprehensively, simultaneously with Western psychology and Western psychotherapy, I personally believe that we can introduce new subject to the field of psychotherapy as Buddhist psychotherapy. 2600 years ago, our Buddha has divided illnesses into two, as physical and mental. At the same place where Buddha explained the pathology of those psychological and physiological illnesses. As far as the psychopathology of psychological illnesses are concerned, Buddha explains they are that as a result of the reciprocal combination of physical elements and the psychological elements and their imbalances, there will be psychological illnesses and abnormal behaviors. For example, when we just look at the desire, hatred and delusion, these are the psychological causes that are leading to psychological illnesses. Imbalance of phlegm, bile and air, these are the physiological elements which are leading as a result of imbalance of these physiological elements, they are leading to some sort of psychological and psychological illnesses and abnormal behaviors. So when we just look at the Buddhist psychotherapeutic approaches towards healing of them, I personally believe that morality, concentration and wisdom as the main approaches that we can use to resolve these sort of psychological illnesses. If we learn and study well all the psychological elements of morality, or see them, so we can use such sort of psychological principles to transform behavior of the client. And if we study well with the help of the psychological understanding all the elements of the concentration, I believe that we can use these sort of things to develop, enhance the knowledge of the client. And finally, wisdom. In Pali we call it as panya. If we study the concept of panya or wisdom well, as a result of these psychological elements, with the help of these psychological elements, so we can use these sort of psychological elements to change the client behavior and the cognition. So I believe that there's a cognitive behavioral transformation modification in the Buddhist psychotherapy. And on the other hand, if we study the Buddhist mental culture, Buddhist meditation comprehensively, according to the early Buddhist and the Theravada Buddhist analysis, there are two types of meditation methods, as Samatha and Vipassana. According to these sort of meditational principles and the psychological approaches, so we can use these sort of approaches towards the Buddhist psychotherapy. According to the mindfulness of physical body, physical elements, so this is the so important psychological approach that we can use to perform the and enhance the awareness of the client physical body, physical body parts. So if we use the mindfulness of feelings with the help of the psychological understanding, psychological analysis, so I believe that we can use these meditational methods to enhance the client's awareness of the feelings. So the mindfulness of thoughts, so with the help of the therapeutic support, if we can use mindfulness of thought, this meditation, to provide the clients to understand his thoughts himself. Finally, we can come to the mindfulness of phenomena, Dhammanupassana. This is a very good Buddhist psychotherapeutic element that we can use to show the clients to see his own psychopathological elements. So if the client practices this mindfulness of Dhammanupassana or phenomena, if we provide the knowledge for him, so he himself can understand what are the my psychological, my psychopathological elements of his psychological problems and abnormal behaviors. And on the other hand, not only these sort of meditational methods, there are other ways in early Buddhism where we can use to enhance the some psychotherapeutic aspects in modern world. For example, when we just look at the some sort of suttas, for example, we can just look at the Sabbhaso Sutta. Here Sabha means the all, Aso means the canker, how to eliminate all kinds of cankers or defilements. In that suttas, we see some sort of approaches where we can understand as the approaches that we can use to have a cognitive behavioral approach. So, with the good understanding of the modern psychological principles, psychotherapeutic principles, we can use these Buddhist teachings to enhance the some arenas of the Western psychotherapy. So now everywhere else in the world universities, there's a trend to apply this Buddhist psychological and Buddhist psychotherapeutic studies. For example, when we just look at the Mahachulalongkorn University in Thailand, so now they have added these Buddhist psychology and Buddhist psychotherapy and Buddhist counseling studies into their syllabuses. When we just look at International Buddhist College of Korat in Thailand, so there is a MA paper which is known as Buddhist psychotherapy and some affiliated college in Malaysia. So we see that now there is a good trend to study and lead the students to understand some sort of psychotherapeutic values and psychological values in Buddhist studies. When we just look at Sri Lankan universities, all the Buddhist and the other Sri Lankan universities, even in the Department of Western Psychology, when we just look at the University of Kelaniya, Department of Philosophy, they have a special paper, BN Psychology. They have added two papers from the Buddhist principles into their Western disciplinaries also. And when we just look at Postgraduate Institute of Pali and Buddhist Studies, they have developed this Buddhist psychotherapy and Buddhist counseling subjects into postgraduate diploma levels and MA levels. So, my personal understanding and my personal belief is that if we study these Buddhist psychological principles with the good understanding of the Western psychological principles, so with the amalgamation of these two disciplinaries, I think we can introduce new subject into the world as Buddhist psychotherapy. Thank you very much.